Welcome to the LNG White Estate. I'm your host, EGW Writings Tech Tips. Today, we're going to learn how to install EGW Writings 2 onto your iOS device. Apple makes iPod Touches, iPad Pros, iPhones, and EGW Writings 2 installs and works beautifully on all of those devices.
Now that you're ready to install EGW Writings 2 onto your iOS device, you need to go ahead and find the App Store icon in the menu and click on it. Once you've opened it up, you need to click on Search and enter into the search box EGW Writings 2. And once you've found it and click on it, it will open up right there in the App Store. If you've previously installed it, you'll see the little download cloud icon. If you've never installed it before, it will say install. And I'm just going to go ahead and click on the download cloud icon there, and it will start to install. While it's installing in the background, we can go ahead and look at the screenshots about some of the features that you can do in EGW Writings 2. You can also expand out more, and you can learn about some of the new features that we have here, like in version 5, like syncing the study center, my library, updated bookshelf, new reader layout, new reader toolbar, and also many additional color themes in the reading screen. I can see that it's now installed, so we're ready to click on open. And while it's opening, you'll see the first time that it will pop up a little wizard. It's just a couple of screens here. You'll notice the first one says, "May we use analytics?" It's very useful to our development team that you click and select yes. The reason why it's useful to select yes, because if the app crashes or it has issues, it will send us crash reports and we can quickly fix them and send out an update. If you click no, then we do not receive those crash reports. We do not sell or utilize that data in any other way than to help us to repair any issues that happen within the app. So we appreciate it if you click yes. The second thing is to download the 125 books of LNG White. This is the core books. If you use them offline in any way, it's useful to have them downloaded. So I'll click on yes and that will download. The third option here is to sign into EGW Cloud. Now, when you sign into EGW Cloud, it enables us to sync all of your study center data, your notes, your highlights, and your bookmarks. It also syncs your search history, your reading history, and your listening history, and all the books that you've downloaded in my library. So all that information is synced and backed up, and if you ever lose your iPad, then it would be automatically backed up in the cloud. You need a data connection to do that, of course. It's also useful if you have two devices and you want to sync your information between two devices, like an iPad and an iPhone, for example. Or if you have a MacBook, it's also useful to be able to sync your information across onto your MacBook. So in that family of EGW Writings 2 for iOS and macOS, you can sync all your data. So to go ahead and sign in, you need to click on the sign in button, and then it takes you to a website here where you have to set up an account. If you already have an account and know your username and password, just go ahead and sign in. Maybe you've signed up in the past but forgotten your password, then you would click on the right hand side there, just above the sign in button, forgot password, you would click on that. But if you don't have an account, then you would need to click on the sign up, and you would go through and fill out all this information. When it's filled out, you would check the little checkbox, creating this account, you accept the end user agreement and the privacy policy, and you can click on the little blue words there if you want to learn more. Once it's all filled out, you would click on sign up. Once you've entered your username and your password, the next thing you need to do is place a check mark beside the box by logging into your account. You agree to the end user license agreement and accept our privacy policy. That is the European regulators GDPR. And if you do not accept that, then I'm sorry, you can't log into EGW Cloud. If you do accept the policy, you can also read the information that's highlighted in blue there to learn what we do, what information we collect, and what we do. We do not share it with any third party, and no one has access to it outside of our development team. And then you can click on Keep Me Signed In, if you want to the next time not have to enter that information. So we're going to go ahead and click sign in now, and you notice that up on the app you were signed in. And there we are, we're right there on our main menu, ready to use EGW Writings. I hope this brief introduction to installing EGW Writings on the app is useful. Next week we're going to learn all about the different components on the main menu and on our side menu, and start week by week on how to learn to use EGW Writings 2 on an iOS device.
Thank you for watching the video on how to install EGW Writings onto your iOS device. If you have any questions and would like to learn more, in the description below there's a link to iOS at lwhite.org. There you can write questions to us and we'll do our best to answer them. If you'd like to comment, you can also write comments there and we may be able to comment back directly on this channel. If you like this video, then make sure that you subscribe to this channel. It helps us to bring you better content. Week by week, we hope to be able to do that, so you can learn how to use EGW Writings 2 and be more beneficial to your study and to your devotional life. Thank you, and God bless.